Okay, so we're looking at the phrase structure of English and the set of constraints that hold for how that phrase structure is constructed. Let's go back to our verb phrase, the verb phrase that we've been looking at. Very often, study my psychology notes on the bus. Now, this is not a complete sentence. We need to add some more stuff to make a complete sentence, but the part of that sentence that we call the verb phrase could be this. And if we look at it in terms of its structure expressed as brackets or bracketing structure, we can take square brackets and put them around words or phrases and label those words or phrases on the left. And nest those structures in such a way as to show what we understand the hierarchical phrase structure to be. But it's kind of hard to read things that way. So what we prefer to do is to show it either in the kinds of structures that I'm showing you with the cubes that are more graphically containers, or we more often do it because it's simpler with phrase structure trees such as this. So we can put the labels for nodes in the tree, and the things under each node are the phrases or containers for other words and phrases that are within them. So the verb phrase can consist of a V-bar, and then that V bar can be expanded in various ways. One way is that an adverb phrase can be placed on the left, and that then is followed by another V bar. So the V bar mechanism allows us to add various adjuncts to the left and to the right. And then we can also add another layer by putting another V bar within the V bar that exists there, and this time we'll put it together with a prepositional phrase or PP on the right. Going back to the V bar that we created with this, we can then finish off that phrase in some sense by adding a complement. So the verb study is the head of the overall phrase, and it can have the thing, the object of study, can be expressed as a determiner phrase or DP on the right. And the prepositional phrase then can be elaborated in the same way. So a prepositional phrase consists of minimally a P bar, and that can then be elaborated as a P bar that minimally contains its P, the head of the prepositional phrase. In this case, it's on, and on, as is typically the case for prepositional phrases, this on preposition head has a complement to the right, which is a DP. And then the complement of study, that DP, can be elaborated in the same way, where the DP minimally contains a D bar. And that D bar minimally contains a D and possibly a complement to its right, which is an NP. So if we look across the different phrase types, we give them this kind of phrase structure rule, the same phrase structure rules or the same kind of phrase structure rules are instantiated across the entire range of lexical categories. So an NP consists of an N bar. An N bar can consist of an N followed by a PP, or an N bar followed by another N bar and a PP in order to give us an adjunct of the head noun. So student from Harvard, for example. A DP, a determiner phrase, can do the same thing. So it minimally contains a D bar and a D bar that minimally contains its head, the D, but can also contain the D plus its complement, as in the case of this person or this group of people. But it can also contain a debar that is followed by an adjunct phrase, as in the case of someone in my class, where the PP functions as an adjunct, modifying the debar. A verb phrase, similarly, minimally consists of a V-bar, and a V-bar with its head, possibly with a complement, which is typically a DP. But it can also have an adjunct like after dinner, in which case there is another V-bar followed by a PP. And a PP has the same set of possibilities, so we can have the preposition functioning as the head with a complement, which is typically a DP, or we can add an adjunct to the right, as in the case of off for a week. So student from Harvard, someone in my class, leave after dinner, off for a week, are all different versions of the same basic structure with an adjunct added into a larger phrase. The N-bar doesn't need to have a complement or an adjunct, and one can go from the N-bar directly to simply an N, in which case we would have people. The same thing with a determiner phrase, where the D-bar can end and complete itself with nothing but a determiner, as in the case of this. And the V-bar can end with simply a V, as in the case of an intransitive verb such as smile. Similarly, a prepositional phrase need not have more within it than a preposition. So the PP is expanded as a P bar, and then the P bar is expanded as simply a P, such as out, as in, I'm gonna go out. Then you can also have structures like this, rebuilding of the city, where you have the N-bar consisting of the head N, rebuilding, and that has a complement, a prepositional phrase of the city. And some of the people, again, within the determiner phrase, you can have a D-bar expanded as a D plus a PP complement. So the complement of any kind of phrase, of the head of any kind of phrase, doesn't need to be a specific category. In all of these cases, we can see that an N, a D, a V, or a P can all have a PP as its complement, or can have other things. So go to the store, we have at the lowest level of that phrase, we have the V bar expanded into a verb, followed by its complement, a PP. And in Back to the Future, we have the head of the overall phrase being back, and it has as its complement the prepositional phrase to the future. So what we get then is a set of phrase structure rules that can be summarized very simply with a schema that can be expressed with the variable x that can be substituted for by any of the lexical categories, adjective, preposition, verb, noun, determiner, adverb. They all can fit within this same structure. So there's really just a single schema for doing all of these kinds of phrases. There's an adjunct rule that allows you to add adjuncts by expanding an X bar, that is an N bar, P bar, D bar, or whatever, into another X bar followed by a phrase. Or you can expand an X bar, and must at some level, into the head. And when you put the head in, you can also put a complement, if there is one, or if you want there to be one. So this is what we call X bar theory. It's called X bar theory because X stands for all of the different categories: adjective, noun, preposition, verb, and all of those categories can be heads and phrases projected from them, and those phrases have the same basic schematic structure in across the whole range of categories.